Hey everyone, welcome back to another Counterside video. So in this video, we are going to be discussing the Gauntlet, particularly your ranked battles in PvP and their usage. So we actually just ended a week of battles and more or less I was able to gather results from them. Then let's find out what is in store for you guys. Okay, so we have here top usage of counters. So counters are your specialists, your heroes in ranked 1.1. Let me actually explain this further. So in our gauntlet, we have ranked battles, right? So ranked 1.1 was just finished about yesterday, so May 23. So it was a week. So the next would be ranked 1.2. So this would be a weekly evaluation in terms of the usage of counters, of mechs, of soldiers, and of your ships as well. So more or less, this will just serve as your guide in terms of who are people using, who are the players using, who is the most used hero, mech, soldier, and ship. So let's start off with this list. This is actually your top usage for counters. So at number one, you have Shaolin, so at 92%. So by the way, guys, this is based on the top 50. So out of the auto 50 players, 92% are actually using Shaolin. So that is how I computed this. It took me a while actually to compute this data. So more or less, Shaolin 92%, and that's roughly what 42 of the 50 are using her. So I'm not sure if I'm right with the math, but more or less it's 92% of the 50 of the top 50 players who played in the recently culminated ranked battles for the gauntlet. So next would be Nanahara Chifuyu. So she is actually your top striker, so at 90% usage. So again, this would actually help you guys on which heroes to focus on for PvP, even for the other one, even for strategy, because this will actually help you set up your team there for your defensive team based also on the build that you have here. So number two again is Nanahara Chifuyu at 90%. Next would be Kyle Wong. So a lot of players I assume have Kyle Wong. So he's at 86% usage. Number four is Yang Harim, which is a very, very good support at 80% usage. Fifth, it is Elizabeth Pendragon, which actually I'm kind of surprised. I was not actually looking for her to be in the top five, but to my surprise, she's there at 70% usage. Next would be Gaeyun at 70% as well. And Shinja, our ranger at 58%. So more or less, from 1 to 6, they are the top in terms of usage from 70 up to 92. The middle, you know, the middle area would consist of Shinja at 58%. Irie Alford, which is actually a defensive character, a shield, so at 38%. Esther Rosa, the Chevalier, is at 36. So these are the mid heroes that you should look out for when you're, you know, attempting to build your PvP team for rank or for strategy. Next would be Evelyn Keller at 26%. So she's our healer. Ryan Ferrier at 26% as well. So again, another shield or another tank. 12 is Lin Xian, which is adds points for deployment. 13 is Nanahara Chinatsu at 22%. 14 is Hilde at 18%, which actually I'm also surprised that she has quite a bit of a usage as well. And 15 is Hyanmi Sanae, which is actually I think she's a sniper and she brings a very big gun, very big ray gun. Sylvia Lena Cooper is actually another sniper, and Seo Yoon will round out the top 15. So more or less, it's a top 15 because the last three actually have the same, so I lumped them up to 15. So more or less, these are your top usages in Counter. So again, a guide on which heroes to focus on when you build your PvP, because for the first week, these are the top usages for your Counters. Next would be your top usage for soldiers slash mech. So for your left side, you have soldiers. So top usage would be your stronghold times 2, 30%. They are bit of a defensive unit with ability to shoot ground and air as well. Terminator times 2 at 4 and Ironside at 4%. For your mechs, just want to put this out. For your mechs, actually, there were a couple of teams there that were really dedicated to mechs. I think two in the top 50. That is why you have their Buzzard, Sparrow, Woodpecker, and Titan. So Titan and Hound usually have splashes within other teams. But the Woodpecker there, Sparrow, and Buzzard, they are composed of mostly mech teams plus Sylvia. So I've seen those teams and I think they're good. They have a lot of potential. You also might want to explore that as part of your PvP, either your PvP in strategy or in ranked battles. So again, these are just guides for you to look at whether you'd go a counter direction, mech direction, and probably have a splash of soldiers. So next, we will have our ships. Okay, so top uses for ships. So more or less, you have the Glipnir, 64%, because this is obvious because most of us, or all of us actually, have the Glipnir because of the rewards for the game. That is why it's top one. Next would be Lake Superior at 16. I will actually cover ships and what they do, what they contribute to PvP, probably in the next video. But for this one, these are Lake Superior is actually SSR. Kumizumi is also SSR. And I'm not sure. Glipnir, sorry. Number five here is Glipnir. That's the other Glipnir, the void type. So there are two Glipnirs, by the way, the one that was given to us and a SSR version. So that at number five, that's the SSR version. I forgot to put it there. And Abraham is actually, I think, forgot what Abraham is, but this actually Abraham. This ship actually was used in mechs. So I'm sure it has ability to help mechs in the team. Okay, so again, data is based on league results as of May 23, 2021 for the top 50 finishers for ranked battle. So you actually have a baseline now on which heroes, mechs, soldiers, ships are being used. So more or less for the second week, you guys will have a much better time in constructing your teams. Me as well, I will be focusing on several heroes leveling up so that I could also be, you know, I could also improve my ranking in rank, because I suck at rank and strategy. I'm only at bronze, so I would like to also go up the ladder and also try to level up those heroes as well, and more or less ships and mechs, or if I'm lucky enough I could get stronghold, I would want to use that team or those soldiers. So more or less, again guys, take this with a grain of salt. This is actually just to guide you. When we have established our PvP, when we have established who is really good in PvP, probably after a month, I will actually include in my weekly videos the top teams as well. Top teams for PvP for that week, so that you guys would be updated and more or less be guided on what is happening in the meta. And if you can also assemble those pieces for that specific team. Okay guys, so thank you for if you've reached this the end of this video, thank you very much. Also, please don't forget to subscribe, because Most of my subscribers are around 17% haven't subscribed yet. So please do, because this helps my channel. Okay, guys, stay safe. Take care. This is The Warden, and I'm out of here.